Okay, so this is part two. If you haven't seen part one, make sure you watch it first. So I replaced the fuel lines because they were bad, and pretty much I had to buy a new carburetor. This is the kit I got. This is the new carburetor. I got this on eBay for around $12 or something like that. So I'm gonna take this apart, remove everything, and try to install a new carburetor. Remove the gas cap. Okay. Put it back. There we go. Now I'm gonna have to remove this tank, gas tank, because I need to get to the carburetor. Okay guys, don't use a drill to do this, okay? Because there's gasoline, and especially if you open this up, because I have to open this up and they have some gas in there to remove this screw here, because this can cause a spark and you don't want any explosion or anything. Okay, so I'm using a wrench from underneath and a screwdriver to remove it. Now I can see the carburetor. Okay, it looks like I have to remove this filter first. There's a screw right over there, right on the filter. So I have to remove that and then see what else I have to remove. I'm using this kind of small screwdriver. Okay, when you remove that bolt, then you just grab it from the bottom because there's like a small, like a white pin right here. You see? So you grab this black plastic and pull it down, and it's gonna release that like a pin right there. It's hard to see, but and there's like two pins on the top. And go ahead and remove it like this. Gonna show you. This is the bottom pin right here. And two on top. That's the pin right here. Okay, then we need to remove the filter. This white filter. It's kind of oily. I don't know what that means. But then we have like two nuts over here that we have to remove. Okay, so I'm gonna use a 516 socket, but you can probably use like 8 millimeter. And I'm gonna use this kind of torque wrench. This way, when I actually unscrew that bolt, this way I can know how many pounds I approximately use. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try this. There's not much space though. Okay, I put 20 pounds, 20 inch pounds, and that's enough to remove it. Maybe it should be less even, but that's the lowest I have here, so I would probably hand tight it or something so I don't over torque. Okay, now the nuts are removed. Just gonna leave it like this. Okay, here's the carpet. My gasoline fell. And the hose actually came off from it. Okay, so this is the new one, and that's the old one that I have. And as you can see, the opening on the inside is slightly different. This one has a smaller hole, and this one has a bigger one. It's actually like this. But I will still install it and see if it works. It may be more powerful or something. We will see. But it does kind of look the same. And the reason I'm changing it is because of the pump right here, the diaphragm, broke on the inside, so it's not pumping this way. It cracked. So if this carburetor will not work, then I will have to probably just remove the diaphragm and reinstall it here, and hope for the good. Okay, so like I told you, this has a smaller hole here, and so what I'm gonna do, as you can see, this one has a bigger hole, and when I put them together, it feels like it's like barely closing that hole. So this, because this one has a smaller hole in it too, so I will install this gasket and see if there will be a leak. That's no good, it's not gonna work. But if there will be no leak, then it's gonna work. So I'm suspecting that this is actually a stronger one, probably more powerful. But let's give it a try and see. Okay, so they actually provided a gasket, so I'm not gonna use this one because it's already like glued to this. So if I take it off, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna ruin it. So I'm just gonna leave it here and I'm gonna install this one. Okay, before installing it, make sure everything is clean around it, like where it's gonna go. Make sure everything is clean. Okay, so I'm gonna change the hoses. This one goes for the vapors that's coming back to the tank, and this one for the gasoline. Hard to get it off. So I'm gonna use a screwdriver. Put it on. Okay. Now I need to replace this on here. Okay. I have to remove this screw. Release it. Oh, that's actually, oh, that's adjustment. So you don't have to use this one. So pretty much you open this up like that. This has to come out. There we go. Okay, so I haven't done this before, so just pull this out like that and take this, move it to the new one, and put the spring back on. Now I have to put that thing on. It's kind of hard. Oh, okay. So you need to make sure that this, like around facing this way, because this one has to go inside from here, because on the other side there's no round thing, like it's like a hole. Okay, so I took it off so it would be easier for me. Okay, so I almost got it in. So just gonna push it inside there. Okay. Finally. Okay. Now I'm ready to install it. Okay. Now I'm gonna clean here as well. So I'm gonna clean this one, the filter. Okay. think I'm gonna use a brake cleaner to clean this off. There's like oil in here. You can see so much oil. I don't know why there's so much oil. Okay, so I brake cleaned it and now I'm gonna dry it. There's still some oil. I'm just gonna use a rug to clean it. Okay. Let's install another filter. This filter has some oil too, so I'm gonna clean it as well. But I'm not gonna use a brake cleaner because it can dissolve this. Just a rub. I also cleaned the filter, like on the inside of that white plastic. And I'm gonna clean this from the oil. And use a blower, a compressor blower. Long way. I'm not gonna use torque pounds because this has plastic. Don't want to crack it. So I'm just gonna make it hand tight. That. I'm just gonna check if it's moving or anything like that. Yep. So good. Okay, now I can go ahead and install the filter. And another filter. Okay. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and insert this, the wafers, and make sure that this one is all the way in, that the filter that's on the bottom is laying right on the bottom, and I'm gonna just go ahead and pour this out because I got some dirt in there. I don't know why, but I don't want this to be dirty. So even though it has like a filter here, but I still want to have clean gas. Okay, so I installed this back. I cleaned the gasoline and I got like just a little bit of gas. And I pumped, and as you can see, the pump is full. And I had to like pull this like a couple of times. And guess what? It started. Yeah. So when it started, it was actually having like high RPMs and it was like pulling, so I had to hold it. And then what I did here, I adjusted this bolt here. That's the RPMs. This screw here, the one I showed you, this one right here. So, and I unscrew it just a bit. Look, there's a huge spider. And so now it's working like perfectly, and it is actually a lot stronger now. I tried it, so I'm gonna show you. I forgot to put the bolt in, so it came off. Okay, so now I have to screw that bolt in so I don't lose it. Okay, so I was actually, and I am happy that it actually worked. Now I'm gonna have to take it for a test drive and see how it's actually working. But I always can adjust that RPM over there. But I like to keep them lower. It sounds kind of better, but it may not be as good to drive, but I will figure this out. Okay, so it drives, but I need to adjust the carburetor to the best, and I need to fill up some gas. I'm not really sure why, but if I give like full throttle, it kind of like stalls, but if I give like halfway, then it actually accelerates. I just need to play with those adjustments, because it kind of looks like it's a little bit different from the original. So if this video was helpful, like and subscribe to my channel. I will adjust it and post different video, and also watch my other videos on pocket bike, and I'll keep you updated. Okay, so this is the adjustment right there. This way you can adjust with the screwdriver here. Also, if I bring this lever down like that, somewhere like right here, then it works fine. I can give full throttle, and it works fine, but it doesn't drive as fast. So, but when I bring it down, bring it up, then it kind of stalls when I give the full throttle. So I have to play with it and see if there is anything I can do with this to improve. If not, then I guess the carburetor itself is not the right one, and then I might replace just the bottom part, like I said, onto the old carburetor. And so I will let you know. Tell me what you think in comments, and see you in the next video.